A family is giving thanks tonight as doctors release from their care one of the teenagers shot during Detroit's tree lighting ceremony. It's been 10 days since the shooting incident near Campus Martius, and tonight one of the 15-year-old victims is back home.
The shooters are still out there, but family members are speaking out, saying this young man is lucky to be alive. Victor Williams witnessed the reunion between the teen and his family. Good evening, Victor.
Yeah. Hey, good evening. It was quite touching. We saw that teenager being wheeled out of Children's Hospital right into the care of loved ones. It was a very close and scary situation for these family members that are still looking for answers and so much more.
It's a blessing that he's still here with us today. Like I say, the shoe could have been very well turned on the other foot.
Community activist Oliver Gann is happy to be walking out of the hospital with his 15-year-old nephew, one of the teens shot after Detroit's busy tree lighting ceremony.
He got shot in the neck, so he still has fragments between his fourth and fifth vertebrae in his back.
One bullet was only 3.5 centimeters from hitting a main artery.
I don't want to see it happen to anybody else. No one wants to see this happen to anybody else, especially downtown, where families are enjoying themselves at an event.
Apparently, it started with an altercation that led to shots being fired. Family members wanted to be known that the teenage victims were just that, victims of gang violence.
They were a gang, but not my son and his little friends. They're really good school kids, you know, go to school, they play basketball, they do what teens supposed to do.
There were a group of men that had been seen walking around downtown, and one of them had ended up accosting one of his friends. And when my nephew and them turned around to see what was going on with their friend, that's when the shots rang out.
His father, who did not want to go on camera, questions why police weren't able to prevent the shooting and why the accused shooters still have yet to be caught.
I'm wondering where were all the cops at? And I know it was busy down there that day, but these guys were all over the internet saying that they were going to do this.
Just to put faces up and say we have people of interest, that's not enough when it happened in downtown Detroit of all places.
Either way, Gant's nonprofit organization, Thousands Strong, is adding to Crime Stoppers' reward in hopes of finding justice.
Whatever Crime Stoppers is putting up, Thousands Strong, we're going to match it. They're just hoping for some justice, that these guys are caught and taken off the street and things of that nature.
Now, the other teen shot is expected to be okay, but DPD at this moment in time is saying that this is still an open investigation and they are taking it very, very seriously. As far as people who might have seen something out there during that Christmas lighting ceremony, you guys are asked to call Crime Stoppers. You can leave an anonymous tip at 1-800-SPEAK-UP. Victor Williams, Local 4.
We have to believe somebody saw something. Sure hope they call. Thank you, Victor.